Looks like classic tractors are coming back to Farming Simulator. What's going on, everybody? DJ Goham here. Welcome back to the channel. Hope you guys are having a great day. We have new mods for Farming Simulator 19. First up, we have the Schuler 2500 VL Classic Tractor. We got a new TGS 41500 IT Runner. Oh yeah, another IT Runner truck. I'm digging it. I'm digging it. We got ourselves a Double Claw. We also have the Gens with Epps Cab. This is cool right here. It's kind of a little bit of a game changer, to be honest. We also got two new plows. We also got a couple new straw barn mods and an update to the large cow pasture. We also got two brand new maps and a map update. Let's check it out. First up today, we have the Schuler 2500 VL. This is a Giants mod, which explains why we haven't seen this in the testing list. It's really cool nonetheless. Let's check it out. What you want to do is you want to go over to Vehicles, Medium Tractors, and you're going to bump over until you start seeing mods. Mine was right after the new Massey mod that we got a couple days ago. Boom, right here. Very, very simple. Very good looking, but very simple. 240 horsepower, goes 19 miles an hour. It actually goes 21 miles an hour, to be honest with you. Trailerborgs or Michelins, and for Trailerborgs and Michelins, you have standards, wides, and twins, respectively, for all of the brands. There you go. Up to about $132,400, so you're going to tack on around $8,400, $8,500 on the main price. How's about that? That's not too bad, is it? Not bad at all. So we have a three-point with PTO on the back with a trailer hitch, and on the front, we have pin hitch. So there you go. What do you guys think? Let's take a look at the inside. Start her up. Hey, that looks good, doesn't it? Nothing too crazy, nothing too fancy. Oh yeah, there's all-wheel steering. There's that. How can I forget all-wheel steering? It does not turn on a dime. It turns on like 30 pallets of dimes. As you can see, I am hard over right now, and it just ain't turning. So just do keep that in mind if you're going to be using this. It does not turn very well, but it's still a beautiful tractor. Giants, you did a good job on this one. Next up, we have the MAN TGS 41500 IT Runner. You're going to find this in Vehicles, Trucks, and you're going to find it right beside the other IT Runner that we have. So now we have the TGX and the TGS. So whatever you like, you can use. Let's jump in, check it out. So main color, we could change this to whatever we want. We do have some custom colors from the modder, which is great. So let's go with a nice little orange rim color. We got a couple new options here. We have silver and we have chrome, which I think the chrome looks amazing. We also have a couple other custom colors in here as well, which all look phenomenal. And design color, we could change the color of the hook in the back. Very cool, very cool. And then wheel brands, we have Trailerborgs and Lizards and Nokians. So if you guys like any of those, be perfectly fine and happy with those. And also we have a couple different engine options as well. We have a 430 horsepower engine, 470 horsepower engine, and a 510 horsepower engine. So you get to choose whatever you like. If you want to deck it out all the way, it's going to cost you about $221,000. And the party piece with this one is dual front wheel steering. What do you think about that? Look at that curl. Look, it's just stanced up. I'm gonna leave it like that. That is a good looking mod right there. Next up, we have the HJM Double Claw, the RAR Claw. Man, this thing is massive, isn't it? Let's check this out. What you wanna do is you wanna go over to Tools, and then you wanna find your wheel loader section. And then it's gonna be right after the CSZ pack, stuff like that. Bam, right there. Now, I've been looking, and other than a couple silage forks that you can use for logging, we don't have anything like this, which makes this really neat and really cool. Can't do anything to it. It's $5,950. Can't change a thing. But boom, right there. Here it is on front of the JCB, so you can see how massive this thing is. It is definitely wider. It is the RAR Claw indeed. It's just a good looking implement right here. And then this is all the way closed right here. So you're definitely going to want to put more than one log in there because that's just going to be a waste of space. I think, what, three probably minimum, something like that. Stick it down there and just clamp them up. There you go. On to our next mod, the Jens HEM 583Z with Epps cab. Now we have had to install the cab. The cab does not come on this. Let's check it out. You're gonna go to Tools, Forestry Equipment, and you're gonna go past the other Jens that we had. And there it is right there. HEM 583Z. Main color you could change to a couple different things. You got a green, a blue, black, red, orange, yellow, bright green. I mean, that is like brighter than silly pea green. And of course, a white. We're going to jump with white. And then we have a red and black color. So you can really make this thing look completely different. I mean, just with those two color changes, we made this thing look absolutely different. Wheel brands, we have Trailerborgs and Michelins. You go standard communal wide tires with the Trailerborgs. And with the Michelins, you go standard or wide. We've gone with wide. And then design, we have basic and the Epps cab. Now, the thing about installing the cab is you can't actually get in there. Let's turn on a help window. See, inner vehicle, it just puts you in the tractor. However, if you swap around, now we're in here. And boom, now we're in here. How's about that? Let's jump here. So you do have to have a tractor on this. you do. You got to have a tractor on this guy right here. Let's bring around. And we are going to pop up. How cool is that? Oh, that's cool. I like that. I like that. Let's see. So, unfold the pipe first. So you got to do a whole bunch of stuff just to get this thing up and running. There's a lot of different things for this. So you see at the top, we've got number 2 selected. Now we're at number 1. This is the pipe. So we can control the pipe wherever this goes. Then we go into 3. And this is controlling the support arm. Down at the bottom, I believe. Let's see. Nope, don't fold it. We can turn it on. Insufficient power available. Okay, so we can't turn it on because the tractor doesn't have enough power. All good. There we go. Boop. And then back over again. Now we can control the arm. We control the arm exactly the way that you guys are used to controlling it. Boom, boom, side to side, up and down, back and forth, towards you, away from you, and then controlling the arm right there. There you go. This is a cool mod. We probably won't be using it because, well, we don't do much logging, unfortunately. But this is going to go handy with a new map that we got today. Got a logging map. Boom. What do you guys think? Going to be using this? It's kind of cool. And I don't think I mentioned, it's a wood chipper. Yeah, it's a wood chipper. You can use this to grab your pieces of wood and pop them there. And then wood chips come out there. Yeah. Didn't know if that was obvious or not. But yeah, it's a wood chipper. Cool. The last implements for today, we got a couple plows. We have a Vernlin BE6. And we have the Lemkin Diamond 12. So let's check these out. What you're going to do is you're going to go to tools. Then you're going to go to plows. Then you're going to bump over till you see them. Boom, right here. The Diamond 12 is going to cost you $45,000. Has a working width of 4.5 meters. Seems to work out just fine. Can't do anything to it. Goes 10 miles per hour. Not 7, but 10 miles per hour. That's big. 4.5 meters at 10 miles per hour. That's all right. The case that we got the other day only goes 7, but it's 5.3. So I think the Diamond 12, that's definitely going to be doing some stuff. And then, of course, we have the Vernlin BE6 right here, $12,000. 1.8 meter working width at 7 miles per hour. It's not so enticing. But nonetheless, let me know. You guys going to be using these? We might be using this Lemkin around. That's a good little setup right there. Yeah. Next up, we have the placeable straw barn. These are great, really, really good. So what you can do with these guys right here, it's just a placeable barn. So if you want to use a barn instead of a bell cell, you can easily do that. Where are you going to find these? You're going to find these in placeables, miscellaneous, and they are down the list. So if you guys have a bunch of stuff installed, get ready to scroll. Here we go. Edge Deluxe Barn black and white. So you got your red, black, and white versions, $50,000. For each one of these, a little high price, you put as many down as you want though, which is great. And it is a sell point. Yeah, it's a placeable sell point. So we've been able to sell things like this before, but not looking this good. They've been functional, but not beautiful. Man, these are cool. And of course, you could see them in the sell point prices as well. Edge Deluxe Barn, that's your red one. And then you have Edge Deluxe Barn Black Edition and White Edition. Prices are different for each one, depending on what time of the day it is and when it is. Just like our in-game sales, you never know. You just get the green or the red arrow that says, hey, I'm doing good, or hey, I'm not doing so hot. Prices are very, very good compared to everything else, at least on this map, on New Woodshire, which is our test map. You could do silage, grass, hay, and straw. So you can sell everything that you would expect that you could, which is great. Silage prices are very good here as well. The biogas plant on this map is a little bit overpriced, so I wouldn't take that as a grand. Yeah, I wouldn't take that. But there you go. What do you guys think? Let's jump inside real quick and just kind of take a look around. Of course, we have a little hayloft up there. Are these, I almost expect to see gold on. I missed 17. Come back. Can we open any of these doors? I don't think so. Very unlikely that we can open any of these doors. No, can't do that. But there you go. What do you guys think? Let me know. Do you like this mod? Are you going to be using this mod? It's giving me chills from 17. Goodness gracious. I love it. And the one and only update, the only mod update that we've got today is the placeable large cow pasture. It is Animal Pen extension ready. So if you guys are on PC using the Animal Pen extension, you are ready to go. It says an even larger cow pasture. The water and straw is brought directly to the pasture with seating under the trees. Yeah, hey, there's no trees ever. I don't know if, like, if you think there's trees. If there's trees for you, let me know. Because I don't have any trees. I've never had trees. I don't even know where they are. Goodness gracious. Why? Why would you say there's trees? There's no trees. Anyway, there's an update for this. Make sure you guys update. Welcome to the map, Prismas Awo. The map consists of 41 areas, 32 arable fields, and 2 forest fields. You can sell crops in 3 stationary purchases and train buying. The train is an important element of the map because it is integrated into the farm. Advantages of the map: a large area with obstacles to horseback riding, sawmill for the trains, loading ramps for the train on the farm and at the store, 32 fields varied in size and shape plus 2 forest areas, train path integrated into the farm, field number 12 prepared for the development of the farm, additional flat fenced area for purchase prepared for additional buildings and mods, good optimization, a well thought out arrangement of roads, tracks, and utility buildings to make the game more enjoyable, many beautiful landscapes and interesting places to explore, and road traffic. So what do you guys think? This is a very cool map. There's a whole lot going on. You got a castle, and you got a little, yeah, a big mountain. Another big mountain. Goodness gracious. It's crazy. Let's take a look at the map real quick. Look at this. A bunch of square fields. You guys like beautiful landscape and square fields, you're gonna love this. It is completely encased in water on about 2 sides, roughly, something like that. A lot of water on the map. It does take up almost the entire 2 times of the map. So do keep that in mind as well. If you guys are curious about what you start with, you got a Fent favorite. You have 2 of the K7210s. We do have the Bison, which I'm not a big fan of. And of course, you got all the rest of stuff. So it's nothing too crazy, nothing too wild. If you guys are looking for storage, this has a 1 million liters? I believe so. Yeah, 1 million liter capacity. So you'll be able to do that. Your main farm here, your main farm silo is integrated into the trains as well, which is phenomenal. It's got a lot of good stuff going on with this map. It's a really, really well thought out map. If you guys like the old farm countryside, I think you're gonna like this one as well. Welcome to Rogue River, a brand new logging map. It says Rogue River is a forestry only map full of challenging terrain. And I can back that up 100%. I had to get up here. This is massive. There's a bajillion trees. I'm not sure how many zeros are in a bajillion. Maybe you guys can help me out down in the comment section below. That's exactly how many trees are on this map. Absolutely crazy. So this is by Catalyzer Gaming and FDR Logging. I was able to chat with Catalyzer very briefly last night about their other map that is in testing. It's not out yet. So Rogue River's out now. This one is tough. It is very tough because there's a lot of crazy terrain, a lot of wildness. Let's check out the map. Boom, right here. There's not much to it, man. You got a sawmill and you've got a store and gas. And that is legit it. Going around, you could see the challenge. The terrain for the map is insane. Of course, you've got all the areas where you can buy, so that is great. You can even buy the river if you want to. Might be the last thing I would buy, but nonetheless, the only thing is you cannot buy. Oh no, you can. Look at that. You can buy the roads. That's what I say. I don't think you can buy the roads. You can buy the roads. The roads are very cheap as well, so that may be a nice, easy way to start, or you know, get started and that kind of thing. Guys, think now. This is a nutso map. What do you get when you start? Well, that's what you get right there. You get a pickup truck, but leased items. You have the Komatsu 931XE and the 875. But keep in mind, these are leased. These are not owned. These are leased. But it's nice that modders are kind of giving you stuff leased right off the bat. Kind of makes you work for it, doesn't it? I like this. This is done very well. And we've got an update to New Bartleshagen. The Animal Pen extension is ready to be used on this map as well right now. And flickering of the map boundary has been fixed. So if you guys are playing on this and you're on PC, you've got that Animal Pen extension. Make sure that you use it on this map because it's ready for it. That's really cool. I like how the modders are using that and getting it and prepared for everybody. I just wish that we could have that on console. That's a big thing. That's why we're not using it on this one. But nonetheless, there you go. We have an update to do Bartleshagen. Make sure you guys update it if you are playing on it. But with all that being said, that is going to be it for today. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please drop a like. If you're not already, please subscribe. If you got any questions, drop those down in the comment section below. And if you have any ideas for a future video, let us know. That being said, hope you have a great day. We'll see you later. Peace.